know. she had me all her life, so I guess my favorite story is them coming in the kitchen and me throwing eggs off the countertop because I was trying to find the ball lady. I was always into something, always. God knows when he calling you to something, he has already put in you what he needs for you to do what he has called you to do. So today he has called me to deliver a word to this body, and I'm excited about it. And I just, come on, clap your hands with me. Y'all clap with me. There we go. Now, I know I can't say it, but I want to make the devil mad for a little bit. We are thankful people, I am always encouraged to lead us. Possessors of life, ready to battle for I appreciate you. So we missed out. Y'all can have a seat. I just wanted to get y'all loosened up. Come on, give me some lights. I have accepted my call.
All right.
And when I say accepting the call, you know, sometimes we want people to respond the way we see them responding for other folks. And some wise guys and different people have explained to me that you're just different. And you know, sometimes we want people to shout and say amen, and that's when we think we're doing something. Not saying that the when we do that, someone is not doing something. But around here, we have a fivefold ministry. Pastors, teachers, evangelists, prophets. And God assured me something, that son, if you teach my word, I'm going to do the rest. And I had to understand something of what he called me for is to teach. Now, the teaching part is the hard part. Because usually you're not getting a response when you're teaching. And you know, I mix a little preaching in there as well. But Pastor Steve said something, and I wanna take what he said to dive us into the message today. And I'm saying this, tricking you really, but not to bore you. I want to teach to you today. Because from what he spoke about entering into a new realm, if we don't know something, then operating in the new would seem like we're still in the old. So now, this is what's going to happen to you. There's going to be some churches around and some people around that's going to be in the new realm, and there's going to be some churches around, and there's going to be some people around from the old realm in the new realm. All right. Now, what you mean by that? It's like this. If God told us to go into the promised land, and some stayed in the wilderness, then you're going to be around some people with a promised land experience, and they're going to be like they're in the wilderness wondering what you shouting about. Did you see the size of those grapes? And they're still at Walmart trying to get some grapes out of the bag. They're trying to decide if they want seedless or non-seedless, the purple one or the green one. That ain't that. I'm talking about God provided grapes. I'm talking about houses that someone else built that God said is yours. No, I'm not speaking about you getting them today, but I'm speaking today about you knowing something. And when you know something, you're going to get something. Because when you know him, there is nothing that he will withhold from my life. Yeah. It's what I don't know about God that's causing me to stay stuck where I am. And he said in his word that he was grieved with a generation for 40 years because they would not believe who he was. Now, some religious folks gonna get mad at me. But I've been around church for a long time, Sister Kathy, and I've been to some churches that I gotta ask the question, is God really here? Now God corrected me on this. What he told me is, son, it is not that I'm not present with them. They just can't see my presence. Yes. Right. He that has ears to hear, let him hear. He that has eyes to see, so God can have right in front of you what you need, but you can't see.
Right.
God can be speaking the word to you, but you can't hear it because it's cluttered up with some things of the world that the enemy wants to put into our ear gates and in our minds to get us distracted from what God is trying to pour into us at all times. So if we're going through a process and we're trying to progress, then if we don't know God, how can we do so?
All right.
See, the world is trying to get themselves fixed. You know, they got together on Capitol Hill to fix health care. I can fix health care in one word: believe.
All right. Believe.
But if you don't know him, you can't fix your situation if you don't know how to fix it.
Right, right.
Y'all may have heard this little joke before, but the plumber comes into the house and the plumber gives the lady asks the plumber to come in because there's water leaking under the faucet. So he goes in there, he assesses the situation, and he said, oh, you just need to change this valve out, easy fix. Matter of fact, I got one in the truck, I'll go grab it and put it on. She's like, oh, that's great. That shouldn't cost that much. Then he come back with $100. Gonna cost you $100. She's like, golly, man, all you did was get one little pipe out your truck and put it on there to stop the leak. He said, ma'am, I'm not charging you for the pipe. For the pipe, I'm just charging you $10. I'm charging you $90 for knowing what to do. See, God is trying to tell you today, I ain't charging you nothing. I put all your bill on the back of my son, and all you got to do is come and get to know me, and I'll show you that I can fix anything in your life. I can turn your darkness into light. I can turn your rivers that's dry into rivers that's flowing with living.
Wow.
God, give me, God, of this living water.
Yeah,
and what he says to the woman at the well is, if you knew who was standing before you, you would ask me of this living water. Now, we got a situation here. We got a Samaritan in the story at a well, and Jesus is at the well also. Now, she's at the well trying to get water out of a physical well. Right. But the spiritual is standing by the physical. Right. What you mean, Brother Lamar? Jesus being the spiritual water that can give the living water. But the well that he's standing by is a natural water stream that can give water to the body. So Jesus is telling her, ma'am, I'm trying to introduce to you a new realm. That in this realm, you will have in you a well that will never run dry. The problem that I have with this is, if I'm in a new realm and my water never runs dry, why are Christians always thirsty? We thirsty because we don't know who it is that has given us this living water. The worst thing in life life is having something available to us, but not knowing that it is. Our sister here just told us something that we didn't even know was available. That if we have dental situation, a situation with your eyes, that we can go to this place and get fixed, but if she wouldn't have spoke that into existence, we wouldn't know that that care is available. Jesus has been standing in your house, in your kitchen, while you've been crying night after night, while you've been struggling, how you was going to do this or how you was going to do that, standing right there in your kitchen and saying, I'm aware that if you would taste of me, you would taste what's in the oven, you checking on it? But I got something in the oven. This church is about to have you on the edge of a breakthrough.
Amen. Amen.
You are going to be able to help others break through what they've been trying to break through all their life. Because here we understand something. That what we know about the Savior and the Holy Spirit is delivering us and bringing us to a place that we know that we can't bring ourselves. So when folks come in and get our pastor, I need you to come down to this place and pray for us. And what he's saying is bring the new realm. What he's saying is bring the fresh oil that God has poured out onto this place. Bring what you doing there, but Pastor, what you mean, Pastor Duke? We talking all the time, man. They're asking us how we did this and how we doing that and how we that and how we did and how we did. We got a pastor that knows God.
Oh yeah.
We got a five-fold ministry that knows God.
Amen.
We got some Wednesday night folk that know God.
Amen.
We got some Sunday morning folk that's getting to know God.
Yeah.
See, I can't give all y'all to know God yet because I don't see some of y'all on Wednesday night. If you know God, you're going to be here Wednesday night. I don't care if it's sprinkling outside or some rain. God gave the rain, so I'm getting into his presence. You know, I live an hour and 15 minutes away, and sometimes it's storming so much that I can't see in front of me. I can't see the road. I can't see nothing. But I do see Jesus, because he's going to get me to the church, and I'm going to get the word that he's presented at the church. Don't be afraid to get up out of your comfort zone and say, I'm sick and tired. My back against the wall. The devil is coming at me, but I know a man, and his name is Jesus. And if I can get to the hem of his own, and if I can just touch the hem, the Holy Ghost touched me over 8 years ago. I ain't shut up since. I ain't gonna shut up until I see everybody in this place on time. You going on top. Top belongs to you. Last time I spoke to you, what I told you? Yeah, now you're on the spot now. It's who turn?
Come on, man.
Come on, y'all say it with me. Say it's my turn. It's my turn. Say I'm next.
I'm next.
Devil, you done messed up. Because he done called. Whatever your number may be, your name is up for a blessing from the kingdom of God. But you got to believe it. Because the blessing is not coming from the old realm or the old way of doing things. The blessing is in the new realm. This one they couldn't get, Pastor Steve. He couldn't bless them where they used to be. See, illustrated like this. Back in the days, they had clothesline. Say, now, where your young people at? Come on, say this with me, young people. Say, not in my day. Say, we got wash and dry. Back in the day, they had clothesline, correct? And they had these little pieces that you used to put on the clothes. I'm outside, I'm like, man, wait, it right. I appreciate y'all pain. Mama, I thank you. But I also thank her for getting more.
Yes.
So yeah, me and my cousins, we looking out here and like, look, man, that look like, that don't look like a clothesline, that look like the finish line. And whoever get through the finish line, that's who wins. So we done made a game out of the clothes, and then my mama, they wondering why they clothes on the ground. He did. It wasn't me. But now I understand something, what God was trying to do. In me was the ability to dry your clothes. I used nature for a season. But now, I'm getting you out of the sun. I'm getting you out of the elements. And I'm providing a way for you to dry your clothes without you having to do anything.
All right. Yeah. Hallelujah.
See, some people can't carry over. Man, that, please, old folk, don't get on me. I'm sorry. I'm in the spirit, so I got to use the illustration that's coming to me. So, and my mama know this story. So my uncle sit down with me. He said, "Son, you ain't a man if you don't cut grass." And I'm like, "And change all. Don't forget to change all. I can't change all, y'all. Last time I changed all in my car, it stopped working." So guess what? I realized God didn't call me to that. So in somebody's eyes, I ain't less of a man because I haven't changed off. But watch what God did to me. He put seed in my pocket that turned into fruit. And then somebody at Walmart got blessed because I brought my car to them. And now they were able to put brain on their table because they had a car that they could change off because God anointed them as the super duper mechanic worker on the cars of the change of the oil. But guess who didn't have that anointing? Me. But I was anointed enough to bring it to this service. So my uncle said, "Well, son, you're not a man because you didn't put your hands on." Now the revelation in this is the world been trying to tell you to put your hands on.
Come on.
Right. Dr. Phil said you got to do it. Oprah said you got to do it. This one said you got to do it. That one said you got to do it. I tried. I couldn't do it. But I knew a Savior that did it. Yeah. So I can do it.
Yeah.
So what he's trying to tell me is stop trying to put the clothes on the line yourself and put them in the dryer that I'm in.
All right.
Now you think the dryer was made by some man. But who gave the man the ability to know how a dryer is?
That's right.
See, we separate ourselves from the world, but who made the world? So God is trying to speak to us through this revelation that what I did yesterday, I'm not doing today to get you to tomorrow. So the process is not to kill you. The process is to get you from point A to point B. But the only way I can progress you is to change your perspective. So what he says is, I'm going to do a new thing.
Yeah,
I'm so happy I'm a new thing. Old things are passed away. Meet the me today. You met me last Sunday. Meet me today. I'm not who I was last Sunday. You know what that means for me? That means I got potential. Stop letting people call you what you used to be.
Come on.
You're not going to be just like your dad. You're not going to be just like your wife. You're not going to be broke all your life. And you're not going to be a bad husband. And you're not going to be a bad wife. You are not your behavior. Because if you was your behavior, you would always be just what your behavior had. But if you can change your behavior, how can you be who you used to be?
Come on.
If I used to lie and steal, and I don't lie and steal no more, can you call me a liar and a steal? Now, just because I sell cars, that don't mean you can call me a liar. Because I'm not a liar. So now that person on the test drive with me called me a liar, I'm putting you out of the car. for false information. Why would a person perceive me as a liar that haven't met me and we on a test drive? Because she's basing my identity off of old habits of other people that's not me. But what she hadn't come into contact with until that day was a kingdom citizen. And when she met a kingdom citizen, her perspective changed because now she realized there are some good people in the world. What are we allowing to formulate our mindset? It's 11:33 and I'm just getting to my topic. We ain't gonna be all day long. Y'all enjoying yourself?
Amen.
I had a little help with this one. Somebody leaned over to me and gave me my message. She's not my wife, she's just my wife. Oh, I told her. Do you really know God? Or what he can do? Brother Ennis, where you at? Do you really know God and what he can do? I call his name because recently he had an experience with the kingdom. Yes. That what the doctors couldn't do, the kingdom stepped in.
Come on.
So now he enters into a percentage. Oh, this 1% is 2%, is 3%. But they just said, I'm not satisfied with that. Because if God say I'm healed, then I'm not 1% healed, 2% healed, 10% healed, or 20%. I'm healed. So when he went back to the doctor, guess what the doctor said? We can see 0. Now what you cannot tell Brother Ennis is he don't know Jesus. The reason some of us say we don't know Jesus is because we're seeing him but not seeing him.
Come on.
I just, because I work in call centers, I'm going to use call centers. You couldn't get the call, but you went into the finance department and things worked out on your behalf and you was able to get the call. And some people say, Mr. Finance Man, I thank you. Man, Mr. Manager, I thank you for providing a way for me. Say it was God, but I just didn't see him. You was driving on the highway on the interstate and you just got into a little worship. Now, I've never been a Christian channel, but you was worshiping.
That's heavy right there.
Come on. Y'all know I ain't got no sense of, so I lost my sense a long time ago. I got the mind of Christ. That's all I need. As long as I got that, we all right. And you're driving and you're just having a good time on the interstate, and all of a sudden the fool goes and cut you off. And you slam on brakes just in time because you were really in worship and you wasn't paying attention, but you slammed on brakes just in time. And you said, man, thank God for them brakes. You thought it was the brakes.
Come on.
But you was entertaining an angel unaware.
Right.
I remember being in the store one time and this person didn't have enough for the food or whatever they were buying. They hadn't already bagged it up. So my flesh was saying to do it so these people could get out of the way. But my spirit man said, bless him. So instead of the cashier having to take the transaction out, I paid for it. And the cashier said these words. Y'all might, it's kind of a cliche term. Who do that? It just opened the door. So I kindly waited for them to leave. And then I told her, who do that? Let me tell you who do that. Say, ma'am, I'm a kingdom citizen.
Right. That's right.
Look, don't. If y'all, look, let me help y'all out real quick, a little plug here. Don't go out witnessing to people telling them about Jesus. They gonna put up their guards quick. Sneak them. Don't tell them you a kingdom citizen. What's that? Let me tell you what I used to be messed up. I was toe down from the floor down. I couldn't get out my own way.
That's right.
The liquor used to find me at every corner. I couldn't wait to get to the store to get me some of that good liquor. God, I was tore up. And then I met this king. And he says, your life is more than what you see right now. I'm going to call you to do a job for me. And now you don't have to do what you're doing on stage for the world, but I'm going to put you on a platform for my kingdom. She said, oh, what the platform looked like, what you was doing, what? She ain't know nothing we're talking about church. She knew, but she all into it too, huh? I said, yeah, I used to do music. I used to rap a little bit. I was getting down in the world. See, that boy, what you doing now? I said, I speak for the king. I said, oh, you royalty?
Yeah.
I said, yeah, I'm royalty. And look, we got openings. Wait, no, you're giving away my description. The world makeovers. See, there and you consider the terror. Oh, we having fun now, y'all. Come here, Sister Norma. Come here, Brother Cal. I'm just in illustration mode today, y'all. Somebody get this. So, Sister Norma come to me and say, oh, she just tired of me. Brother Cal need a makeover. So, Sister Norma puts him in my possession and say, make him over for me. So, I don't have no skills to make you over, but you gotta trust me. You have a seat. See, most people that sitting in here today that don't know God, you trying to get made up before you get to the makeup.
All right.
Let me tell you what I'm trying to tell you. You can't get yourself right and then come.
Right.
If you're coming to get yourself right. Let me get this side over here. You can't come when you get yourself right if you're coming to get right. And we learn in Ephesians that we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works. Now, if we know Brother Cav's story of what he came from and what he came out of, and who, I mean, I know him from Billy Ball, did the loudest mouth at the at the field. I remember as a kid, I'm like, who that dude is, man? He's just loud. And then here I get 10 years later, one of my good friends.
Yeah.
I can guarantee you, both of us wouldn't have been friends with the old us.
No. Come on, brother. All right.
But just like me and him, God put us in his chair, on his potter's wheel. And we ain't have to look back at him and say, this is how I want to be fixed up.
Right?
Yeah, let's walk right there for a second. Because some of us want God to fix us the way we want to be fixed. Oh, I'm about to get into somebody cool in. You trying to get fixed up for a husband you want. But God trying to fix you for the husband he wants sent to you. So maybe you need to stop looking for the wrong stuff and wondering why you get into the situation that you're in, and that ain't the one God called for you, because you ain't been fully made yet.
Come on. Come
on.
Right.
I hate Steve Harvey, but this sounds good. If you want to be a wife, stop thinking like a boo.
Wow. Come on.
I don't know who this, I'm speaking to somebody, y'all. It's coming out for a reason. Because God said you got more to offer than what you present.
Yeah.
You can't come to God and tell God, this is how I want to be fixed. God said, I'm the one that went to life school. Woo! See, I got to talk, I think I'm a life coach sometime. I'm going to be life coach, pastor, life coach, they all the same. And some of the people that consider themselves life coach, they're saying what they believe. They doctor to be. I don't see none of that. I got the easiest job in the world. Because I don't have to do the cleaning, fixing, or the making. All I have to do is introduce him to the workman, who puts the life together how he sees fit. All I have to do is know him and how he operates. And he has poured out of his spirit upon me. Now this is the other catch. even though you get up from the chair and go back to your respective place, the good thing about this makeup artist is you never stop being fully me. See, if you go to, I can't think of nowhere else, so if you go to Walmart and sit in their chair, they make up your hair, make up your face, and then you get up and you leave, you pay them, and then now it's going to be undone. And you got to go back. Come on, y'all, stay with me in the illustration. Now you got to go back to them to fix you. But God says in the new realm, I'm doing a new thing. You don't have to come to the beautician to fix your hair. The beautician is coming to you. See, this is the part about the Christian walk that I got that people can't get. Because you keep trying to go to somebody. Religious organization come in Sunday after Sunday and try to go to God.